Hello guys, today we are going to discuss about the structure and the content of eyeball in this dummy and about the description about the structure and content of the eyeballs including the visual pathway and the refractive error we have already discussed in the previous video. You can check it in the link below. So guys, this is the dummy of the eyeball and here we are going to discuss about the structure and its contents. You can see here the anterior 1/6 part is formed by the cornea and the posterior 5/6 part is formed by the sclera. The sclera is white part. This is the white part and you can see a transparent anterior 1/6 part. This is cornea. So we are going to take out it. This is the cornea, which is transparent. Now let's discuss about the other layers. The second layer is known as uveal tract. From behind to forward, you can see here the choroid, and in front of the choroid there is triangular muscular area which is known as ciliary muscles, and in front of which there is another structure known as iris. I am going to show you the iris. This is the iris, in which it is centrally perforated, known as pupil. The iris is also known as adjustable diaphragm because it adjusts the pupil and it maintains the entering of the light into the eye. And behind this layer, uveal tract, there is another layer known as retina, which is the most sensory layer. I'm going to take it off and show you the retina. This is the retina. The innermost layer, this is the retina, which consists of rods and cone cells. Cone cells for the bright vision or color vision and rod cells for the dark vision or black and white vision. So here you can see the different chambers of the eye. It consists of the anterior segment and posterior segment. In the anterior segment, it has got two chambers, that is anterior chamber and posterior chamber, which are separated by the iris, which consists of the aqueous humor, that is this is cornea, and between the cornea and the iris there is anterior chamber, and between the iris and the lens there is posterior chamber, which both consist of the aqueous humor. And behind this, the large part, this is also known as vitreous body or vitreous chamber, which consists of the vitreous humor. And in this, aqueous humor is composed of chlorine, amino acid, glucose, urea, non-proteinous nitrogenous substance and also oxygen. And this is the vitreous. In the vitreous humor, it consists of the water, collagen like fibers, hyaluronic acid mainly, N-acetyl glucosamine and glucuronic acid, and also the soluble proteins. So if there is overproduction of this aqueous humor or there is inadequate in the drainage of this aqueous humor, then there is a condition that rises known as glaucoma. And for the treatment of the glaucoma, different drugs such as pilocarpine, physostigmine, acetazolamide, tremolol is used. And the normal intraocular pressure of the eye is 16 to 23 millimeter of mercury. So now let's talk about the blood vessels supply of the eyeball. And I have already discussed about the central artery in the previous video. You can check it in the link below. So the main supply of the eyeball is central artery and vein. You can see here the red color having the central artery and the blue color is the central vein. And from it, it goes to along the ciliary muscles, that is long posterior ciliary artery, which supplies the iris. And here you can see the ciliary artery and the vein, which supply the triangular area, that is ciliary muscles. And also is supply in front of the ciliary muscles, there is conjunctiva. The conjunctiva is also supplied by the ciliary artery and the venous drain into the ciliary vein. And from all the veins from the eyeball that drains into this bigger vein, which is known as varicose vein. The extraocular muscles are superior rectus muscle, inferior rectus muscle, medial rectus muscle, and this is the lateral rectus muscle. And you can see the oblique muscles, that is superior oblique muscle, and this is inferior oblique muscle. So now inferior oblique muscle. So now here the movement of these muscles in on the eyeball. The superior rectus muscles causes elevation of the eyeball in the vertical axis, elevation of the eyeball, and this is the inferior rectus muscles causes depression of the eyeball in the vertical axis. And it also causes superior oblique muscles and inferior oblique muscles on the horizontal axis. It causes adduction and the medial movement of the eyeball, that causes medial rotation of the eyeball and adduction. And this is the medial rectus muscle, which causes the movement of the eyeball medially, that rotates the eyeball medially on the horizontal axis. And this is the lateral rectus muscles, which causes the movement of the eyeball laterally, that is rotates laterally on the horizontal axis. So the two oblique muscles, the superior oblique muscle and the inferior oblique muscle, the superior oblique muscles causes rotation of the eyeball towards laterally and also depresses the eyeball, which means depresses and laterally, means downward and lateral. And the inferior oblique muscle, it causes the movement of the eyeball by rotating laterally and elevation of the eyeball, that is upward and laterally, by inferior oblique muscle, upward and laterally. So these are the movement of the eyeball. Thank you for watching the video. Please do not forget to like, comment and subscribe our channel.